In the energy quadrant, crude oil stormed up to the top of the range, no pun intended, but I'll talk about that in a second. Getting all the way up to 43.57 in that October contract, that was a spike of about 2.2%. On the low side, we hit 42.31, which was just short of 0.75% lower, finished up about 1.57 in terms of percentage change. And as I mentioned, back up to the top of the range that it's been in basically the entire month. And really since about June 5th, if you look at that range, it flattened out at the start of August, but really was a small, tight, sort of upward sloping channel that began around June 5th, started to make higher highs and higher lows, and then flattened out over the last month or so. Actually, for the last 2 or 3 days, looked like it was weakening, not substantially, but kind of hanging out at the bottom of that range in the 41-42 price area. And then, as I mentioned, just popped up there today on a pretty strong single day move, at least relative to the moves we've had lately. Tropical storm Laura, as I mentioned, storming to the top of the range, has become a hurricane now as it gets into the warm waters of the Gulf. Unusually warm waters has helped to kind of pick up strength and pick up speed. It's expected now to be a Category 3 hurricane by the time it hits land, which is expected now Wednesday night, Thursday morning, depending on if it picks up speed or slows. And it's a wide range of landfall that it can make from Houston all the way up to Louisiana. So different parts of the energy sector could be hit. Category 3 hurricane is about 75 mile an hour winds, could do significant damage, but at the very least, it's going to shutter operations as it gets closer. And again, we're already at Tuesday, so that shuttering is probably happening already. So we'll see if it gets up to Category 3. It's expected to, could get a little hotter than that, but we'll see. Sometimes these things hit landfall and they die off immediately. Very unpredictable. Remember, Tropical Storm Marco is right behind it, and that's likely to pick up strength as well, although right now it is still a tropical storm. So Hurricane Laura, formerly known as Tropical Storm Laura, picking up strength and speed. And lastly, we've got the EIA tomorrow. Draws are likely to be smaller, leading to builds. Now, the estimates for the draw for tomorrow is anywhere from 8.7 million barrel draw in crude oil to 3.7 million barrel draw in crude oil and about 1.7 in gasoline. So the range is wide in crude oil, as always, a little bit smaller in gasoline, but they're starting to shrink overall. Refinery utilization is starting to not grow as it has been, still above 80 last week. As a matter of fact, it was a slight downtick. And then also rig counts were up 11 last week. And that may not seem like much, but it's really the first time that rig counts were up substantially. And what I mean by substantially, not one or two rigs, since January of 2020. Prior to that, you've seen it be up one rig, up two rig, but never up double digits until you get all the way back to like January of this year. So overall, it looks like we might start slowing on the upside unless the hurricane hits and hits hard, restricting some of that supply that we've seen from that area.